The stuff I got packed definitely looks like bomb.
A TikToker who goes by the handle Barfly7777 decided that on his flight, the complimentary peanuts just weren't enough. He wasn't gonna be satisfied with them. So he decided to take matters into his own hands during this flight and cook up a gourmet meal. And you're about to watch what I'm talking about in the next video. Let's take a look. All right, so Cenk, off the phone for a minute. We're working here, okay? So here he is. He is not trying to bomb the plane, even though it appears like that. He is setting up the plane's bathroom to make mashed potatoes and garlic shrimp. And I literally can't even look at it without wanting to gag. It's so disgusting. It's one of the most disgusting things I have ever seen, because we've all been in the bathroom on an airplane and it's just so wrong. All of it is so wrong, but why do we need to do this? No one needs to do this, no one wants to do this. I would rather starve, okay? I would rather be on an international flight from like Los Angeles to Thailand, okay? And not eat anything than eat whatever he just made there. Disgusting.
So
it's unnecessary. No one wants this.
So one of the original co-founders and co-hosts of the Young Turks was Ben Mankiewicz. And he still does shows with us from time to time. And he had a great line about plane bathrooms. He said, I said, have you ever gone on a plane bathroom? Because a guy came up in a conversation on one of our shows, old school. And he said, I would rather be hospitalized than go inside a plane bathroom. It's like, there's no way I would ever do that, okay?
But like, what do you?
Okay, so.
But when you gotta go, you gotta go. You have no choice.
I don't agree with him, right?
Yeah.
But, and he means, you know.
Look, I do agree with him, but I mean, what other option do you have?
Well.
When nature calls.
No, I hear you. I don't know how he does it. I don't know.
He flies a lot too.
Yeah, I don't know how he does it, but.
It's crazy.
But anyways, if you told him, what would it take for you to eat that mashed potato, garlic shrimp?
No, never.
He's like, you couldn't pay him enough money. There isn't anything that you could get him to do to eat that thing that the guy made in a plain bathroom sink. Have you ever been in a plane bathroom?
Oh my God, it's so disgusting. It's so disgusting.
And of all the things, mashed potatoes that you mashed in a plane bathroom sink. I mean, he did live up to his name of Barfly. I mean, that so why is he doing this? Because in this day and age, all anybody wants is attention. So
because he wants bangers and trash. That's what he wants. Okay, that's what he's looking for. So congratulations. Right?
So because if he gets caught with the bomb looking thing, right? Mm-hmm. Then he's gonna get huge attention and he's gonna say, no, it's not for bombs. It's for the garlic shrimp I was gonna make. And gets huge media attention for that. Or he doesn't get caught and he actually makes the video and shows it. And here we are giving him attention. So mission accomplished, brother, I hear you.
Can we, okay, so I'm gonna read you his caption for that TikTok post. This is what he writes. With two 6-volt batteries wired in series to an immersion beverage heater, one is able to get water scalding hot quickly. By the way, he's doing this on a flight. I don't know if something could potentially go wrong here, but maybe don't do this.
Oh, God!
Aside from the disgusting element of it, like, don't do this. It's just a bad idea, but let me continue.
There's another reason not to do it, but go ahead.
Raw shrimp will only need a few minutes. Adding instant mash to the shrimp water, add some extra flavor.
Does it?
Garlic butter makes everything go better. And then this is the-
That's the only part that's true.
The hashtags, that's the real reason why I wanna read this. Hashtag, terrible idea, what time? So he seems to acknowledge it's a terrible idea.
Of course, that's why he's doing it.
Hashtag shrimp, hashtag garlic shrimp, hashtag mashed potatoes, hashtag flying, hashtag bathroom chef. Now it gets good. Hashtag how to cook properly.
Wrong.
Is it? Okay, hashtag innovation, private chef, new idea, hack, and then splice. Listen, none of this is a good idea. This is not how to cook properly. In fact, you can actually get very sick considering the E. coli situation in that airplane bathroom. Let's get to some details here. So airplane cabins are basically like germ farms. In just 8 hours, just one cell of E. coli can become a colony of more than 12 million cells. Your tray table alone likely has more germs than than a toilet seat or a cell phone. Cell phones are fine. I think it's BS when people say cell phones are dirty. For example, one study revealed that tray tables contained more than 2,000 colony forming units of bacteria per square inch.
Great.
So I have a friend who actually worked as a flight attendant, and this person had disclosed the unsanitary conditions on these flights, and now I literally will not fly unless I have like Clorox wipes in my purse, like wipe down the chairs like as much as I can, the trays, every like it's I'm so disgusted by all of it. And think about how quickly they do the turnaround, right? The flight comes in, you're about to board, you board within 10 minutes. It really in 10 minutes they're going to clean that nasty plane? They're going to disinfect it.
Yeah.
They're going to disinfect it. Oh, but I have a great idea. Why don't we go into like the nasty urine-stained bathroom and make shrimp and mashies? No, no one wants this. No one asked for it.
Yeah. So I have a lot of things to say. I watched the episode of Monk a long time ago, you know, the defective detective, you all know it. And he did this, he's a germaphobe in the show, and he did this like ultraviolet light or something in a hotel room that showed
terrible.
All the bacteria.
So bad.
And it was like one of those things that I was like, I really wish you hadn't done that. Because now I can't get it out of my head.
There's sperm everywhere.
Oh, okay. I don't want
to
talk.
But it's true.
About it. I don't want to talk.
Okay,
about
sorry.
Okay. And so and then on a plane, as she was describing all the bacteria on the plane, I was thinking, oh, whatever, it's okay. I travel all the time. Then I realized, as Anna was talking, wait a minute, I get sick all the time when I travel. I wonder if that's why. So, oops. And so it's like when people say, like, oh yeah, but people used to eat dirt all the time back in the day. Yeah, they also died when they were 23. So it's not always the greatest idea. And people on planes are crazy. So this lady, so I'm traveling so much now, and this lady, I was about to get in the seat, and she spilled coffee on my seat by accident, no problem. Then she didn't clean it up.
No, I can't.
I'm like, wait, but you're gonna clean it up, right? I just saw you spill it, and you're looking at me like, and she didn't clean it up. I had to find a way to clean it myself. It was unbelievable.
Do you understand why I want to live in a rural part of the country? Do you not understand?
No, I understand it. I understand. I don't necessarily, I agree at times, not always. Anyways, back to this guy. Here's the other problem with this idea. He's making everyone else wait. There's gonna be a giant line while this some bitch is cooking up garlic shrimp and mashed potatoes in the bathroom. Okay.
But also, there's one other person who makes a really good point, because there are people who are allergic to shellfish. So let's go to that post. Shellfish allergy up 1,000% just from that sink. Yeah, I mean, if you have like a severe allergy to shellfish and you end up using that bathroom and you get like weird shrimp juice all over yourself.
Terrible. Yeah, and he put it all over the sink. That's where you would wash your hands and touch it and
so
stuff.
Wrong.
Okay, so look, final thing on this guy is that if your mission was to get attention, nice job, mission accomplished. If your mission was to get hired as hashtag private chef, less accomplished.
But, okay. But I do have a final question for you, Uyghur. You weren't here when we covered this story, but there was an incident involving RFK Jr. because he was on a flight and he decided to walk into the plane's bathroom completely barefoot. Let's take a look, we have evidence of this. So that's him walking to the bathroom, but he did walk into the bathroom completely barefoot.
Yep.
What's more disgusting, the meal that was cooked in that bathroom or walking barefoot into that bathroom?
Oh, Jesus.
Tough.
Look. So no, it's not tough. It's the meal is definitely worse, but you're nuts to walk in barefoot. On the other hand, it's not like Bobby Kennedy Jr. hasn't proven that he's nuts before. So it's kind of, he's working on a theme here.
Yeah.
To be fair to the brother, he is jacked.
Sure, yes. Yeah, I guess he's working on his immune system.
Yeah, maybe. Let no one say we weren't fair.
Thanks for watching the video, guys. We also love it if you hit the join button below, because that makes you a member, and members allow us to be independent, honest. We could be as progressive as we want, no corporate media influence, and that's all because of you guys. We love doing the show with our members. Hit the join button, become one of the Young Turks.